And suddenly, Brother Bing told me yesterday that I will share this topic, transformation. So when we were in Hong Kong, I was so actively going with Brother Jim, Brother Bingbong, and some priests giving retreats, recollection, and Life in the Spirit seminar. But God is good. I'm back. So, the topic for today is transformation. There's a story last year that there's a young guy who just completed his Life in the Spirit seminar in Love Club community in Las Vegas. And on the last day, so he left the LSS. After that, he decided to walk in Las Vegas Strip. So while walking along the street, he saw a lot of things, a lot of people. Then, far from the place, he saw a nightclub. And he said, "Oh Lord, I just came from LSS. And here comes the temptation. So I will close my eyes." So he closed his eyes, and he keeps walking, and he opened. And then again, as he approaches the nightclub, again he was reminded by the thoughts. And I should not dwell into temptation anymore because I'm renewed. So I said, I will close my eyes again. So he closed his eyes. And he keeps walking towards the nightclub. And then, all the while, he found himself inside the nightclub. And he said, "Lord, close your eyes." He asked the Lord to close his eyes instead of closing his eyes. So, that's a good start. Transformation is a process of, you know, converting something. Converting an expression or a function into a thing that has the same value. For example, I have a $1, you know, bill. This is $1, but if I crumpled it, it transformed into a different, you know, figure, right? But the value is still the same. That happens to us. Brother Jim already explained from God's love to salvation to, you know, to the baptism, that the original plan of God, the image and likeness of God, was taken out from us. Ninakaw, nasira, because of we committed sin. And so the Life in the Spirit seminar is helping us from a crumpled person, from a sin person, or a deformed person, to go back to the original, you know, the original look, which is the image and likeness of God. You know, the image and likeness of God is, many times we try to, you know, we want to change things in our lives, especially December or January, di ba, hababa, we have a list of New Year's resolution. I don't do this anymore, I don't go to there anymore, I don't cheat anymore. A lot of New Year's resolution. For the first month, yeah, we're good. Second month, we're good. But on the third month, maybe, we go back to our old life. Why? Why we're failing many times? Even we have a good plan, we have a good, you know, intention. It is because the transformation that we want, we are using our own strength. We are using our own power, something. But the good news is that through this Life in the Spirit seminar, after the baptism, the Holy Spirit already started transforming us. So that means to be successful in, you know, to be transformed into the image and likeness of God, we need to have the power of the Holy Spirit. Pag wala po yung banal na Espiritu Santo sa atin, kahit anong gawin natin, we'll go back to our old life. Kung mainitip lagi ang ulo mo, at gusto mong magbago, but you're trying, you're using your power to, you know, to be transformed, you will fail. But if you rely on the Holy Spirit, if you rely on God, the Holy Spirit, mas mabilis pa sa alas 4 na dumating para, you know, para baguhin ka. And many times in my life, that's what I had experienced. That's what I learned from the renewal. 1991 po, January 1991, when I first attended My Life in the Spirit seminar, I was so down. I was rejected by my company. I was, you know, terminated because my employer in the Philippines, they want me to do something which I really don't like, which because, you know, magigilty ako dahil it's a corruption thing. Because I'm being an engineer, many times we do a lot of, you know, corruptions. If you're not strong enough, you will get into it. So I rejected their offer, what they want, and from that moment I took a jeep, because my job was in that circle, the elliptical circle in Quezon City, and took the jeep. Then I passed by Quezon City, Quezon Boulevard. I saw a lot of people dressed in white. They're happily, joyfully singing and dancing. So I was curious, and then I stepped down and, you know, get inside. And I realized that it's the first day of the Life in the Spirit seminar in Loveland, Quezon City. Then the ushers put me in front, yeah? So at first I was so down, then when the topic God's love started, changes my heart, started to touch my heart until I completed my Life in the Spirit seminar. So Life in the Spirit seminar, don't put a disimula. Like you, may perhaps this is your first day to experience the renewal of your heart, of your mind, of everything in your life. So, sabi nga, if God started, He will finish it. So God wants to transform you. God wants you to be like Him. God wants to use you to be the channel of blessings for other people. Some of you might be, you know, become like Sister Mirna, became the elder of Las Vegas. Pag narinig nyo, if you have pinapakinggan namin yung naging paano nagkaroon ng Las Vegas dito, wow, we were really so amazed how God used Sister Mirna to start this Love Lab in Las Vegas. Yeah. So, we need the Holy Spirit to be transformed. John 10:10, Brother James said, John 10:10, that he explained well that what we are looking for is a life in fullness. A complete kind of life. Diba yung nahihanap natin? Kaya nga tayo nagtatrabaho, kaya nga tayo, that's the reason why we're searching to different, you know, things in life. We're clinging to different things in life because we're searching for a complete kind of life. Complete kind of life. That's why the Holy Spirit will make us complete. And the Holy Spirit will give us power. But the good news is that the Holy Spirit will give us power. After this LSS, after you go out, once you go out to that, you know, to that main door there, problems are still there. Your racist neighbors still there. Your colleague, your staff mate at work, who always put you down, always, you know, scrutinize you, they're always there. Your enemy is still there. Your maybe you in-laws mo na hindi mo ka laging galing sa'yo, nandiyan pa rin. And another thing maybe is, before you started the Life and Spirit seminar, maybe one evil spirit was with you, but he cannot enter because this is for God. So he just stepped there. But he is observing there outside. Sabi niya, lumalakas yung aking alaga. I need more kakampi. So he gets more legions, perhaps, of evil spirit. So paglabas mo natin, nandiyan pa rin yung mga evil spirit, baka dumami pa sila kasi mas malakas ka ngayon. Alam niya na mas malakas ka kasi kasama mo ang Diyos. So gagawin niya lahat para ibalik ka uli sa dati. Lord, evil spirits will be waiting for you there to drag you back to where you were. The good news is, if you rely on Him, if you rely on the power of God, you will always be saved. You will overcome any struggle or any problem, any challenge in your life, any trials in your life, because God is in control. The Holy Spirit is in control. So, another thing in my experience before, lagi akong I always feel shy and timid, you know, because I came from a background of medyo hindi magandang pamilya. I will share to later. So the effect of that, you know, bad background happened na I became more shy, more timid. I always at the back. I cannot speak. I don't know how to speak. I don't know why I'm here right now. But before I cannot even, you know, if I'm in front, I'm trembling really. But because of the power of the Holy Spirit, I don't know what He did to me. He just asked me to serve. Brother Jim said, when you serve, you will get changed. And you, when you serve, sabi pa niya, you will get healed. I was healed by so many, you know, things, bad things in life. But because of the Holy Spirit, I'm slowly getting healed. And the transformation is still continuing in my life. Hindi pa tapos ang Diyos. Siguro matatapos ang Diyos pag ako'y papunta na sa Kanya. Because every day, little by little, every day, God is changing me. Little by little, every way, God is changing me. Gayun din po kayo, so all of you there, here, little by little, God is changing. And the good thing is, hindi ka na nag-isa, you're not alone. You're not by all yourself. You have already someone to help you. The Holy Spirit will comfort you. The Holy Spirit will guide you. The Holy Spirit will be your judge. You know, He will be your defender. Many times, lalo tayo, especially us immigrants, especially us our color is different. Sometimes it's unavoidable that they will be, sometimes they are racist guys, right? I feel that many times. But I always think about Him. Sabi ko, even if no one will understand me, no one will support me, as long as I trust my God, He will defend me. Sabi niya, if you are with me, no one will be against you. Kaya nga, all of us who are here, we are blessed today because God will surely, the grace of God is sufficient enough for us, you know, to overcome all those trials, all those weaknesses. And sometimes, good things, if we don't love God, will put us into destruction. Kahit mabuti, kahit, even if our intention, even if our plan is good, but if we don't include God, it will, you know, convey us to destruction. Ganda yung plano, pero makasarili. If it's selfish desire, you want to serve because for yourself alone, then, you know, it will lead to destruction. I've seen a lot of things like that. But even bad things happen in your life, if you love God, it will become a blessing. That's the good thing, that's the good news about having the Holy Spirit in your life. You know, when I attended the Life of the Spirit seminar, the Spirit is already in us. When we received the baptism when we were a child, the Holy Spirit is already in us. But the Holy Spirit moves through the Life of the Spirit seminar because we allow the Holy Spirit to be in control of our life. So that's the transformation that the Holy Spirit will help us. So what we should do to be transformed, so the Holy Spirit will be the one to transform us, not us. So what we should do is to cooperate with the Holy Spirit. Cooperate. Trust God. If there are trials coming in our lives, in our way, trust God. You know what I learned in the charismatic, mula nung ako naging charismatic ay, every time there's a problem, I learned to think about, oh, there's a blessing coming. Every time there's any challenge in my life, I always think about, Lord, ano naman yung blessing na bibigay mo? Mukhang maganda to ah. Dati di ako ganun. Pag may challenge, laging complain, laging sinisisi ko yung kung sino-sino. But now, I realize that if you have something, you know, medyo nahihirapan ka, praise the Lord, kagad, praise the Lord. Why? Because, you know, God, we said in our prayer na Jesus is the sculptor. Kuminsan masakit yung chisel niya eh. Sometimes it's very sharp, but the chisel is sharp. Minsan yung pag-chop niya sa atin masakit. But we need to endure that, you know, that trials. We need to endure it.